Be glad to be in church this morning. This side's quiet.
I'm glad.
Not this side.
Hallelujah.
Well, maybe just this side stopped up. Is that what it was? We're going to do something a little different this morning for Sunday school. How many of you want to participate?
Yeah.
Some hands are quick to go up, but others are ready to leave the door now. If you would go ahead and put that first, the 10 things. We want to go over 10 things that God, 10 things God wants me to remember. And I'll give you them one by one. We'll read the scripture, but I want you to participate in basically you're going to teach this one with each one of them. You may not get through all of them. You may have to just give the list of the rest of them. It depends on how many participate, which is fine. But I'm going to have at least one or two speak for each thing that he wants us to remember. And I'd wanted to do this one time before, but it didn't work out that way. The first thing that he wants us to remember is he's there for you. He's there for you. He's there for you. Anybody have a testimony or something that you can say or that you can recall right now about him being there for you? Could have been when you felt alone. You know, go along that line or what you may feel. Is anyone right away?
Pastor Stewart, it's been 16 years since Charles has been gone, but I still thank the Lord because he was there for me when I needed him, and he's been there for me every day since, and I praise him for that.
Could y'all hear her?
No.
Something wrong with my ears.
Who
else?
Brother Stewart, I just want to say he's there for me in all the little bitty things.
Yes.
When I lose my car keys, when I just need a little bit of help,
that's the truth.
He's there.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Right before he said, I went to get a haircut one day off Florida Boulevard, and I get my little SUV. I had the time to get ready to come home, and battery light comes on. So, well, you know, big deal. I'm only 2 miles from the house. When I get there, I'll check it out. And I started on. Well, I got, once I turned by McDonald's to go down to go get 1019, it started lurching and acting up, and I could tell it was the alternator wasn't charging more, just on the battery. And of course, my car slowed down. They got people behind me blowing the horn and flipping me off and everything, like I'm doing that on purpose. You know, people just something. And I said, Lord, I said to my mechanic, he lives just right in turn of my neighborhood, a couple of houses. I said, Lord, just get me to the house and I get out and look at it for me, you know. And I just left it at that. He will or he he won't, you know, and I kind of felt a little guilty, see, you know, he's probably something simple like this, you know, really, that's not what I thought about it, you know. And that little old truck, it had a hard time, but I turned in the neighborhood, and two houses was his house, and I pulled up, as soon as I pulled up to his garage, he'd work on the kid. That was it. So, he's in the little things as well as the big things.
Yes.
Don't be afraid to ask him for any help anytime. But he's sitting there waiting to help.
That's right.
Amen.
You know, oftentimes when questions are asked like this, never seen anyone in my life that would pray over a car like hers. She would pull in that church parking lot and you would think, how in the world? She got prayed over. She drove it for like 10 years and didn't go the way it should have been going. But she would tell the story, little things that God was always there for. Genesis 28:15 is a scripture we're going to tie with this one. If you got it, Mike. It says, and behold, I am with thee, and will keep thee in all places whether thou goest, and will bring thee again to this land. For I will not leave thee until I have done that which I have spoken to thee of. That's the scripture reference I'm going to use for that. I'm going to go to number two. This is one that everybody can feel for sure. And the second thing he wants us to remember is he loves you. He loves you. Now, if you don't want the mic, that's fine. I can hear y'all better down here. I think it's the air conditioners up there. I can hear y'all. But I can hear better down here. An example. When was the last time he reminded you?
Every day.
Anyone in particular? Just you? Proof all around us. We don't even have to look anywhere. It's there. Especially when he went to that cross for us. He didn't have to do anything else for us. That was enough proof for us right there. Anyone else, real quick, or y'all just want to get through these?
Sin that had ever been committed, ever would be committed. And he took that on him, and the thing he had to be is that, is the way it hit me, is he experienced what it was to be lost. For a moment, he experienced what it was to be lost, because that's what loss is, separation from God. That's what eternity without God would be, being lost. You would eternally be separated from that love of God. And just for that one moment in time, he had to feel that so that he could be, as the scripture says, touched by and touched.
Yes.
And it just hit me so powerful that he knows.
Yes.
He knows. And he loves him. No doubt that he loves him.
At that moment, my God, my God. So, this is a plug. But yeah, if you don't have Brother Robert Martin, you don't know who he is. He preached here a couple years ago. He was my pastor for several years in the 90s. My mom's pastor her probably the last 30 years of her life. But it's called Pierced. It's a very, very good book.
I know he loves me every time I call him. And I see the results.
Yes. Scripture, of course, for this is very common. Even if people don't go to church, they know it. That's John 3:16.
good answer.
We can all probably quote that. Real powerful scripture.
Yes.
Yeah, his love. The third thing he wants us to remember is that he believes in you.
Mm-hmm.
He believes in you. Okay, Tracy.
I know he believes in me from the opportunities he's given me during the last year.
I was backslidden a while after my mother passed away. I had a few good home in church after a while, and was in the world. But he believed in me enough where the Bible says that he knew us before we were ever, he knew our name before we were ever in our ministry. He knew, he saw me on the throne, and he had enough faith in me to call me back to him and give me another chance. Believed in me, and that means a lot to me, because even though we fail, you know, when we come back to God or when we first receive the Holy Ghost, we're going to fail. We are not perfect, and we won't be until we cross over. But he believes enough in me that when I do fail, he picks me up.
Amen.
He just gives me that second chance. It just goes on and on and on. And I'm thankful for that, that he believes in me enough that he does that.
It's that little unction.
Yeah.
When I first felt called, and I thought that, well, that's, you know, push that aside. But he believed so much in me that he just continued on. He could have turned his back and said, you know what, she's stubborn, she's not going to, but he just kept on and reassured me that he believed that I was worthy, because I don't feel I'm worthy of the calling that he's placed on my life. Through his word, through the word of other ministers that have spoken into my life, and more than anything, it's the word of God that speaks and lets me know that he believes in me.
That's like what happened last year.
So letting you in here know what happened Friday. I don't know if it goes along with this one, but I had money in my savings, I had money in my checking account, and I think I texted my dad about 11 that night, and all of my money was gone, down to the penny. Well, got up the next morning, called the bank, and come to find out when I was getting unemployment for COVID, stimulus money I owed. So they took everything I had. I was at my mom's, and she was talking to her boyfriend about it, and he just felt the need, and he sent me $300 to make sure that all my bills were paid and my kids had a day. So,
that's all.
The scripture for that is 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9. You are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth praises unto him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Amen. The fourth thing he wants to remind us of is, and I would like to hear, I'm glad you all are speaking, but let's try to hear from someone that has not yet, if you feel like you want to. But the fourth thing he wants us to remember is he will not fail you. He will not fail you. Anyone that has not spoken up yet? Scripture for this is Joshua chapter 21 and verse 45. There fail not aught of any good thing which the Lord has spoken to the house of Israel. All came to pass. Let's move to the fifth thing he wants us to remember, and that is that he will be with you. He will be with you. Again, if there's anybody that hasn't spoke yet, if you want to go ahead. Rachel.
Someone that's already spoke up, want to add something?
Okay, but he shows up and shows me he's got it.
Scripture for this is, I'll jump to your feet and won't shout. Isaiah 41 and verse 10. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed. That word dismayed can be discouraged, disgruntled, disappointed. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. He'll be with you. Hallelujah. The sixth thing he wants us to remember, he will provide. Say something about that. Most of you know, when I first came here in 2013, I just got to make surgery, or one or two at that time, and doctor said I couldn't ever work again, despite my disability insurance, something like that. And so for several years there, and people don't believe me to this day, the only thing I lived off of was what the church was able to give to me as being part of the ministry here. And I'll tell you now, it's $400 a month. Of course, I had others during the time this God provided in between. I didn't just get fat the last 5 years. I never was without food. Never was I anything that I needed. He always provided for me. And now I'm going to say this just to plant some seeds into you, that even though it was $400, and if Sister Neville was here today, she can tell you that I never missed paying or giving my tithes off that $400. And I gave it to some of the other ministries here in this church out of that $400. God always provided. And you come too late to tell me that he won't provide for you. And real quickly, time's got to do with us, but we often quote Matthew 6:33. How many knows that right off? At least the first part. Seek ye first the kingdom of God, his righteousness, and all these things shall be added. We usually quote that verse as this is where we need to put God first and da 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 da. But if you go back in context of what that scripture right there is talking about, read the 8 or 9, 10 verses before that, I think starting in verse 24 or 25, he's talking about clothes, he's talking about food, he's talking about taking care of the lilies, those things. When it says seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness and all these things, go back up to those previous verses, and that's what he was talking about there. Now, if we want to talk about putting God first, we go, I think it's Proverbs 3, lean not on your own understanding. Those groups of scriptures right there tells you that's the scriptures that we need to go to when we talk about putting God first. But when we talk about God providing for us, putting him first, he's going to provide all these things that we need to live, that we need to survive on this earth.
Amen.
So he will provide for you. You had your hand in raised, Brother Dan?
Okay.
Well,
he does provide.
Yeah, he does. He does. Scripture for this, Philippians 4:19. Philippians 4:19. My God shall supply all your need according to his riches and glory in Christ Jesus. What time is it?
A lot of people get confused, I think, with need and want. He's not Santa Claus. He's not the fairy, the good fairy, tooth fairy. He will supply your needs.
Amen.
You ain't going to do without what you need.
That's right.
The car may be like you talked about. May not be no one with the new heated seats and all, but it'll be a good horse that at least get you from here to there.
Yes.
That's right. Come on. That's so right.
Need. You supply your need. Long remember that.
Amen. Since it's already 10:35, I'm going to mention the next four and the scriptures that go with them. Give me a moment to write them down if you like. Number seven things he wants us to remember is he will bless you. He will bless you. And the scripture for that is Genesis 12, verse 2. Genesis 12, and verse 2. Those that are writing, you got it. The eighth thing he wants us to remember, and this is a hard thing for us to grasp. Out of all the things we've mentioned so far, he will give you rest. He will give you rest. And of course, the scripture for that is Matthew 11, verse 28. Matthew 11, verse 28. Y'all got it? The ninth thing he wants us to remember, he will strengthen you. He will strengthen you. Several scriptures for this. Psalms 46, 1. Then we have Isaiah again, Isaiah 41, verse 10. And verse 13. Isaiah 41, 10, and 13. And the 10th thing that he wants us to remember, he will answer you.
Yes, yes.
He will answer you. And probably one of, if not my most favorite verse in all the Bible, Jeremiah 33. And verse 3. Call unto me. You know what that those three words, you can replace it with one word. Pray. Pray, and I will answer thee. call to me and I'll answer thee and show thee great and mighty things which thou knowest not. Those are 10 things that he wants us to remember. Now, I don't know if she wrote these down or if she found them somewhere, but I found this in the middle of my mom's Bible once I was going through all her things and everything. And preparing for this Sunday, I come across that again and wanted to share with you. Like I said, I don't know if she came up with them or if some, but I wanted to share them with you this morning. And there's a lot more, but that's 10 there. Amen. I hope you enjoyed this morning. We're going to take just a couple minutes break, and we're going to start a few minutes early with worship as we can do a little something to honor the veterans that are here this morning.